Good morning, students. Today we are going to see in the data handling histogram. Okay, in the last period we have learned about bar graph, double bar graph, also unorganized, organized data. Unorganized data, what is meant by organized data. We have learned about the grouping data. Now in this lecture we will see histogram, how to draw the histogram. Okay, so here let us, we will consider that the marks obtained by the 60 students in the mathematics test. Here frequency distribution table is already given out, right? So I have done their frequency distribution table from the students. In the class total students are 60. Okay, yesterday we have learned about how to make the group frequency distribution table. Okay, so according to that here I make the class intervals of this marks. These are the marks. Okay, so marks I have distributed like this: 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60. Okay, so actually 60 marks are not there, but the students who got out 50 marks, that students will not come in this class 40 to 50. That students will come in this class 50 to 60. So here that class extra, one class is there 50 to 60. Okay, so 0 to 10 class, how many students are there? 2 students. This frequency means number of students that got the marks between the 0 to 10. Here this 10 are the number of students that got the marks between 10 and 20, right? Like this one marks, this one student got the 50 out of 50 marks. Okay, so like this, from this distribution table we can say that if the question is there, which class having the greater frequency. Okay, so which class having the greater frequency? 21. Okay, it means that there are the more students than other students. Here in this, the students got 20 to 30 marks. There are the, how many students are there? 21 students. So this class having the greater frequency means number of students are more than other classes. Okay, so here we will draw this graph according to this information. Okay, now see, 0 to 10 means 0 to 10, 10 to 20, like this groups are there. Then we have to draw the, we have to point out this point on which axis? This your x axis, and here on y axis. Okay, so 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 and 60, right? Now here see, here are the marks, number of students. Here the number of students got the 0 to 10 marks like this, 2. So in this frequency distribution table, what is the lowest number? Lowest number is 1, and what is the greatest number? 21. Okay, so we can take either 1, 2, 3, it is possible on the one graph paper, it is possible, it is, but it is lengthy, so we can select the numbers like this: 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, means the gap of 2 to each. Okay, so now 0 to 10, how many students are there? 2 students. Okay, so this is group from 0 to 10. So how to draw this, how to make sure this graphical representation 0 to 10. So from the 0 to 10, how many students are there? 2 students are there. So 0 to 10, so these are the first information, right? 0 to 10. Then 10 to 20, is there a gap between this? Yesterday, before yesterday in the lecture we have done, so in the graph, single bar graph and double bar graph, after that one gap was there and next number is here. Okay, then one gap is there, then another number is there. So each and every here on the x axis there was a gap. Okay, so such types of examples, such a type of graphical representation is there in the single bar graph or double bar graph. Okay, so here this is histogram. Okay, now see, 0 to 10, 2 students, 10 to 20, how many students are there? 10. So this is the group of 10 to 20, right? Now you remember in the last bar graph and double bar graph, there was not like this. So first we will draw this 10, 10 to 20, how many students are there? 10 students. Okay, so 10 to 20. So where are the 10 students? So here. So we will draw this vertical line with the scale 10 to 20. Okay, then 20 to 30, how many students are there? 21. So we will go for this 20 here in the middle of this is the 21 and this is 22. Okay, so directly we will go to this. Okay, so 10 to 21, we will draw this. So 10 to 20 to 30, how many students are there? 21 students are there here. Then 30 to 40, how many students? 19 students. So here 19, this is 30 to 40, 19 students are there. Okay, then 40 to 57 students, 40 to 57 students. So here this 7 line, because this 6 and 8, so middle number is 7. Okay, so 7, 40 to 50, and 50 to 60 is only 1 student. So 50 to 60, this is 0, here 1 and this 2, so 1 of these. Okay, 1 student. Now I will write 0 to 10, how many students are there? 2 students. 10 to 20, how many students? 10 students. 20 to 30, how many students? 21 students. And 30 to 40, how many students are there? 19 students. 40 to 50, how many students? 7 students. And this 50 to 60, how many students? 1 student. Okay, now the graphical representation in such a way that there is a no gap between the each columns. Okay, so each bar we can say, then such a type of graphical representation is called histogram. Okay, there is a no gap between the each bar, then continues in 0 to 10 directly attached to 10 to 20, then 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60. So in between each crack there is a no gap, right? So this is called a histogram. So in this graphical representation, if we see the x-axis and y-axis, so here 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50 and 50 to 60. The information is given about the each class is continuous, right? So 0 to 10, continuously 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60. These vertical bars are attached together continuously. There is no gap between this, means there is no like this graphical representation. Okay, so suppose this like this presentation is not there, is it there? No, right? So if like this graphical representation is there, then it is called bar graph. Okay, and if the graphical representation is like this, then it is double bar graph. Okay, but here also this continuous and here also the bars are continuous, right? Means this vertical columns are continuous, but in this if you see properly there is a gap, here is also gap, in between this also gap, there will be also gap. In again if you see about this graphical representation, this is the double bar graph. Okay, so in this double bar graph there is also gap. After taking these two continuous bars, there is again one gap is there. Afterward this, okay, continuous means double bar graph, there is also gap. So continuously like this. So there is a gap, and in this graphical representation, there is a no gap between the each bar. Okay, each one bar or each two bar. बार. सो सच ए टाइप ऑफ ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन इज कॉल्ड हिस्टोग्राम. ओके, सच ए टाइप ऑफ ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन इज कॉल्ड हिस्टोग्राम. Afterwards, this is called the width of column. Okay, this is called width. Understood? So this width is same 0 to 10, 10 to 20. The gap is of 10 inch, right? So this is the width of the column. Okay, or this is the width of this bar. Okay. Class interval. If it gap there 0 to 10 continuously, 10 to 20. 21 to 30 is there? No. Immediately 20 to 30. So there is a no gap between the class interval. Here there is a no gap between the each bar. Okay. Or there is no gap between the bars as there is a no gap between the class interval. So such a type of graphical representation is called histogram. Understood? Now here, then see this one bar. What is the height of the bar? Height of the bar is what? 2. What is the height of the bar? This 10. What is the height of this bar? 21, this 19, this 7 and this 1. Okay. So this height of the bar represent the frequency of that class. Okay. Height of the bar. What is the height of this bar? Is 21. So 21 is the frequency of which class? 20 to 30. Okay. 21 is the frequency of 20 to 30. So this is the height of this class. Understood? Now from the histogram we can come to understand, or from the, if the histogram is given and suppose the few questions are given on that, then we can easily answer. See how many total students of this class, or how many total students are there. Then how we can find out the total students? We will add this to 12, 21, 19, 7 and 21. So total students are, how many are there? 60. Okay, total students are 60. Again, if they ask the question, which class has highest frequency? Which class has highest frequency? 20 to 30. Okay, or the question is like, which class has the maximum frequency? The maximum frequency of the class, which class? 22. Then one more question we can ask, how many students got the marks between the 10 to 20? So how many students got the marks 10 to 20? So 10 students. So in this way, this histogram, one thing is very important, that see here, when we will draw the histogram, we are taken this 0, 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30 means 0, 10 to up to 60 to the downside. So what are these? What is this? These are the marks. Okay, what are these? These are the marks. So we have to represent with this arrow line. These are the marks, okay, obtained by the students. Okay, these are the marks obtained by the students, or marks of the students. This is very important part when you will draw the histogram, bar graph, double bar graph. Okay, so we have to represent what is here on the x-axis. And what are these? Numbers represent? These numbers represent what frequency? Frequency means what? Number of students. So we will write here with this arrow marks, number of students. Okay, this is very important. If anyone will ask you what this this is the histogram. What about this histogram? So from this and this we can say that this histogram shows the marks obtained by the students. Okay, this is the histogram of about the marks obtained by the students in any test. Okay, one more examples of this histogram, then we will see what is the difference in that previous histogram and this one is histogram. Okay, now here the class interval and the frequency is given, right? Class interval of the ages in years, and here the frequency is number of teachers. Means here we have calculated the teacher's age, okay, and we have divided the age, or we have named the groups of ages, that 20 to 25, means this 20 years to 25 years, 25 to 30, 30 to 35, 35 to 40, 40 to 45, and 45 to 50 years. This class interval shows the years, age in the years, right? So the teachers, those whose age 20, more than 20 but less than 25, like this, how many teachers are there? 4 teachers. Here the teacher, those whose age is 25 years, more than 25 but less than 30. So how many teachers are there? 5 teachers. So similarly, like this, 30 to 35, 35 to 40, and lastly 45 to 50, means teachers having, the teacher, those whose age is 45, more than 45 but less than 50. So like this, how many teachers are there? 5 teachers are there. So what we will write in this, if you have to draw the histogram, then what we have to write below this horizontal line, this line represent what? Frequency will be there, or class interval will be there? Yes, class interval will be there, right? So class interval started from 20 to 25, and our numbers are starting from what? 0. Our numbers are starting from 0. So here directly 20. So there are the missings. Of course, the teacher's age is not less than 20, correct? No? So here this teacher's age started from 20. So below 20 there is no any number. So now there are no any teachers that having the age is below 20. So our number is started from 20, 25, 25 to 30. So like this. So I will write here, this I will keep the gap, this 20, then 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55. Okay, 55 is not there. Then, okay, so here the missing from the 0 to 20. So we will write from 0 to 20 here this line, because there are the numbers are missing, and this line is called jagged line. Which line? Jagged line. So jagged line represent there is a no any number between 0 to 20. Okay, so the class started from 20 to 55 last. Okay, so this shows, we have to write what it represents, this 20, 25, 30, this represents what? Age in years. Okay, this represents age in years. And what is here? Of course, there are the number of students, there are the number of teachers, means frequency. Okay, so here number of teachers. Okay, so frequency of each class, this, that the teachers belongs to the age group from 20 to 25, 25 to 30, and so on. So what is your lowest number? Your lowest number is 2, and these numbers are less than 10. So we can take the one by one class, we can take the 1, 2, 3 like this readings on this graph paper. Okay, so here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 in. Okay, now the teachers from the age 22, 25. So like this, how many teachers are there? 4 teachers. So we will draw this from line from these 4. Okay, we have to use the scale to accurate marking. Okay, 22, 25. How many teachers are there? 4 teachers. Okay, so 4 is the frequency of this class. Okay, 4 is the frequency of the class. Then 25 to 30, how many are there? 5. So here, from this, 5 teachers are there. Okay, so here see, 20 to 25, this gap, and 20 to 25 and 25 to 30, the gap is same. So this is what? Width of the class interval. Okay, so width, this is called width of the class interval. Then so here these are the bars with the equal width. Here width is here, what is the width? 5. And what is here width is 5. So bar with the equal width, there is a no gap between the each bar. Then next one is 30 to 35. How many are there, teacher? 6 teachers. So 30 to 35, where is the 6? So we will continue here from this 6. Okay. So here teachers are 5. From this we can say that representation, we also can say that there are how many teachers? 6 teachers, then 32, 35 to 40. How many are there? 3. 35 to 40. How many are there? 3. So here 3 will come. 35 to 40. Okay. So for that purpose we have to use the scale. How many are there? 35 to 40. 3 teachers are there. Then 40 to 45, 2 teachers. 40 to 45, 2 teachers means here will come, right? 40 to 45. And 45 to 50, how many teachers are there? Only 5 teachers. Okay, 45 to 50, how many? 5 teachers. So 5 teachers means we have to go up till this. Okay. Okay, so each bar with the equal width, there is no gap between the each bar. Okay, so this is also the histogram. Okay, so when in the given data or when ungrouped data is given and we are preparing the group frequency distribution table, and if you find that there is a first 0 to 10 or 0 to 20 up till that missings are there, okay, after preparing the data, group means class interval, then in the previous example or in the previous histogram we have learned continuous from 0 to 10 group was there, 0 to 10, 10 to 20, the class interval came like this. But in this example the class interval started from 20 to 25. So for 0 to 20 there are missing. So when the missings are there, we have to show them with the jagged line. Okay, this is called jagged line. Means here 0 to 20 the numbers are missing. In 0 to 20 there is no any data. Understood? So this is a graphical, this is graphical representation is known as histogram. Okay. So here from this graphical representation, if the question will ask like this, okay. So now everyone understood everyone understood that histogram. Okay. So if only the histograms are given, then we can find the answers from that histogram, whatever the question will ask. Okay. Or if the data is given, we have to prepare the group frequency distribution table and afterwards we have to draw the histogram, right? Now in this histogram, here the histogram shows or histogram represent the ages in the years of the some teachers. Okay, this is the histogram of about information of the teacher's age. Okay, now the questions are asked like this: how many teachers are age of 45 years or more, means how many teachers are there they having the age is 45 years. But 45 years or more 45 years, right? More than 45 years, but less than 50 years. Understood? Now from this also we can understood, or from this table also we can understood. The teachers having the age is more than, or age is 45 years. So 45 years will age will come here in which class? This class? No, not at all, because this class belongs to the age of 40 years. This class the teachers will come, the teacher's age is 40 years, more than 40 years but less than 45 years. Okay, so the teacher whose age is 45 years, that teachers will not come in this class, of course, right? The teachers whose age is 45 years, that teachers will come in this class. Suppose my age is supposed to be the 45 years. So in which class I will come? I will come in this class, 45 to 50. Okay, so in this class, the teachers whose age is 45 years or more than 45 years but less than 50 years. Okay, so the question is same. How many teachers are the age of 45 years or more, means more than 45 years but less than 50 years? Okay, so which one group is there? 45 to 50. So how many teachers are there? 5 teachers. Okay, so what is your answer will be there? 5 teachers. Okay. And in which class they are belonging? In which class? 45 to, or in which class interval? 45 to 50. Understood? Now next question is supposed to be the how many teachers are of age less than 35 years. Less than 35 years means, see here the classes are there, or from here we can see this 30 to 35. Here 30 to 35 group means what? The age of the teacher is 30, more than 30 but less than 35. So like this, how many teachers are there? 6 teachers. Now see, not your answer is 6 only. The question is what? How many teachers are of age less than 35 years? So less than 35, which class will be there here? The age is 30, more than 30, but less than 35. Getting? Age of the teachers is 30 years, more than 30 years, but less than 35 years. So like this, how many teachers are there? 6 teachers. Okay, but it is proper answer? No. So above this, all the classes represent the ages of 20 to 25, 25 to 30. It means that all the teachers whose the ages from these classes are less than 35 only. Correct, na? This 20 to 25, 25 to 30, and the class interval whose the age belonging from the 30. More than 30 but less than 35. So all the teachers will come in this class whose age is less than 35 years. So like this, how many teachers are there? This. Okay. So 5, 6 plus 5, 11. 11 plus 4. How many are there? 15. Okay. So how many teachers are there? Those whose age is less than 35 years? 15 teachers. Okay. Understood everyone? Now we will see the next pie chart on the next period. Thank you.